Hi everyone, welcome back to the Learn Scriptcase from Scratch video series. So we're in part 4 still, going through all the different applications and developing our system. And in this video, we're looking at the dashboard applications. So as you can see, we're in part 4 here, getting towards the end of part 4, but this is the longest part of the series. So let's go ahead and look at what dashboards do. So as you know, we're using Global Music Supply, a fictional company, as a case study to kind of guide us through this process. So David, the CEO, wants a way to quickly access these charts and grids in one place. So there's a few different charts and grids that are going to be useful for David to kind of get an executive summary on how the inventory is doing. So dashboards are what's going to allow us to do that. They allow us to show multiple applications on one page. We can move them around, we can control the area that they take up. And so they're very useful and very simple as well. So let's go ahead and go over to our development environment and build a dashboard for David to use. Okay, so here we are in our reports folder in our development environment. There's these charts that we have created in previous videos. So I'm going to go up to new application to create our dashboard application. So new application, wait for that to load, and then select dashboard here. So we've got all these different types. We've built charts before. We're going to put those in our dashboard, right, like so. We can name it. I'm going to leave it dashboard for now. And then go ahead and click create on this. And then wait for that to load. And then once that loads, we can start selecting different applications to add to our dashboard. So there we go. There is our canvas there that we can kind of draw on. So this is kind of a drop and click interface. We have one widget on. A widget is just an element that we put on the dashboard. We can have a link widget or an index widget. This is going to be a link. So I click edit on this one. We have one by default. I'm going to link it here to our chart recordings application, right, like so. So as you can see, it's linked there. And then we can go to toolbar to control what is displayed on that application. I'm going to leave all of these off. I don't want any buttons displayed on the application. And then here we have some different properties here. So we can make it collapsible, removable. We can put a header on it, maximize it, move it around. We don't want it moved around for this. We're going to keep it simple. So we're just going to remove the application margin to keep it nice and clean. And there we have added our first widget. Now we're going to add another link widget here. And this is going to be our other chart. So we've added recordings. Now we're going to add instruments. And again, nothing on the toolbar. And again, I'm going to turn all these elements off of the properties here except for remove application margin to keep it nice and clean. Go ahead and hit save on that. And there we've got two widgets. Now we're going to add a grid. So two charts now. Now we're going to add a grid. And we can name these widgets however we want them. I'm leaving them to the default names. So here we've added the grid instruments and we can define where the link for the form goes. We can have it open up a new widget. We're going to leave it to the default, take everything off the toolbar again, and remove all the properties as well. Turn them all off except for the application margin. So there we go. Hit save on that. That's going to put it right down there like so. Let's spread this one out at the bottom. So we have two on the top and then one on the bottom. And this isn't quite done, but let's go ahead and expand this a little bit. Just getting some of the UI set up and then we can run it and see what we think after that and make some more adjustments. So as you can see, you can just kind of drag these elements around and expand them how you want. And then we're going to go ahead and run this. Wait for it to load here. And it's saving the application, generating it now. And now we can go over to our dashboard and see what it looks like here. Wait for it to come on the screen. And the charts take just a little bit longer to load depending on your browser. Okay. So it doesn't look too bad. I like the general layout, but maybe that grid should go down at the bottom and keep the charts up on the top. So let's take our grid application down below. Let me drag it up there. So I'm going to make our chart over here a little bit smaller and put it up on the top. And then our grid's going to go down on the bottom like so. And I'm going to expand that out. That'll make it look a little bit nicer since the data can go all the way across the screen like so. And then keep our charts on the top. Let's go ahead and run that now and see if that looks a little bit better. So wait for this to load, generating the source, and then we can go over to that application now that it is loaded. Okay, so waiting for the charts to load here. There we go. So now the charts are on the top, and since they take up less room, that's good. And then the grid is down on the bottom to see all of that. So that's a very simple way to make a dashboard. You can also add indexes. So indexes are just kind of a statistical piece of information. So you can link it to a table. So maybe if you have some currency that's measured over time, you could measure your profits. If you have some accounting applications, you can measure your profits over the given quarter or the given year or something. So some different options for that as well. So that's how you create dashboards in Scriptcase, and they can be very useful and look really nice and professional.